La sfârșitul lunii septembrie, UTV a fost prezent pentru al treilea an consecutiv în Ibiza, insula pe care cei mai populari DJ ai lumii dau cele mai spectaculoase petreceri săptămână de săptămână și unde publicul se distrează fără niciun strop de inhibiții. Bineînțeles, am fost prezenți și la cea de-a 15-a ediție DJ Awards, ceremonia care celebrează munca celor mai cunoscuți DJ din lume, acolo unde am avut ocazia să vorbim cu Armin Van Buuren, Maxi Jazz, Nightmares on Wax și Luciano. Ceea ce ne-a surprins este că toți și-au adus aminte de România și de publicul minunat de la noi.
Să vedem cine o să câștige în această seară în principale categorii muzicale. What can we expect this year from DJ Awards?
Basically, what I expect is that you don't gonna have bad time. You're gonna have a lot of fun, and we don't expect much more. Just have a good time with all together, all the DJs. By the way, the DJ Awards, always what I say, is not a competition; it's a celebration.
The winner of the International DJ with Pioneer DJ has over 25 million listeners to his radio show, which gets syndicated to over 25 countries across the world. The show is called Star Charts. The winner is Armin Van Buuren.
Thank you so much. All the guys you see as nominees, I'm a big fan of, you know. They've all are big inspiration, so I'm lost for words. I want to dedicate this award to all my fans. Thank you so much. Thank you, Pasha. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
International DJ 2012, Armin Van Buuren.
How was Ibiza for you this year?
Well, every DJ will say great. And for me, it really was great because I moved from space to privilege. And it was a big step, and I was very nervous. but I was very happy that it was a success because, you know, Pasha space are only like 2,500 people. It looks really full. A privilege, 2,500 people looks empty. So it was a big gamble. But we really put in a lot of production and a lot of work to make it really, you know, special. And for me, you know, it was a highlight in my career because I recorded my CD there live. I did my new video there. We did the closing party live on the radio. I did my solo set there. Yeah, it was really great, man.
And, at the beginning of October, you will launch a documentary about your year with Armin.
Yes.
What are your expectations from that?
Well, a year with Armin Van Buuren is there was two camera guys that have been following me around for a year. They were very personal because they were everywhere. They were in my bedroom, they were in my kitchen, they were in my gym. I think it's a very personal documentary. I didn't change the movie. They could do everything they wanted because I wanted to show the people that I really do a lot, like my radio show. People say, oh, he doesn't do it himself, but I really make the radio show myself, you know. I think it's very important that the people understand this, that this is my radio show. And same thing with productions. So I want to show the people a little bit of the side of my real life. You know, a lot of people only know me from my videos or my when they see me DJing, but they don't know. A lot of people were asking like, "How is it with your daughter?" Or I'm like, "Why not show them so they know?"
When you were a little kid, did you wish to be a great composer like Jean-Michel Jarre? What
yes.
are your thoughts about that now?
Well, I can never be Jean-Michel Jarre because he's a unique human being and he's a composer I really admire. But I dreamed of doing something with music because music is very close to my heart, you know. When I'm not talking to you or sitting here, I go home and I listen to music. So there's always music where I am. And so it's a very personal thing. And to be honest, I never really dreamed of being very rich or having a lot of girls or expensive cars. For me, it was really like, I really dream I can make this kind of track. You know, I want to make a track with an orchestra, for example, and I did. You know, for me to make the track was such a, yeah, such a beautiful thing. And when you play the track with the orchestra in front of a crowd of 20,000 people, it's like, wow, you know, this is very special. So for me, I don't think I need to prove myself anymore with awards. Of course, it's really nice when you get them. I'm really happy. But I really still have a lot of music in me that I want to make.
How do you cope with the family life now of being a father?
It's all about balance, you know. I was here in Ibiza for 3 weeks. I only DJed on Mondays. And my wife is here and my little daughter as well. So I had 3 weeks to really cuddle with her and to play games with her and everything. It was really nice.
What's your opinion on the Romanian music stage?
There's a lot of talent from Romania, a lot of talent. I mean, a lot of trans talent even, you know. I think even Andrew Rael, isn't he? He's from Moldova, right? That's close to Romania. Yeah.
So,
yeah, the public. I was just in Romania and playing in near Constanta on the ocean, the Black Sea coast. Amazing gig. For Asvan, amazing gig, really amazing gig. I think the Romanian crowd has been one of my most loyal crowd. Ever since I first came to Romania, they've always been following me and what I do. It's really amazing.
Thank you very much. Everybody knows I changed my style a couple years ago, and to win this award today with all those amazing names behind me is a big honor for me. But thank you very much, and I also want to thank Pasha and the Pasha team, because this year they really took care of me on Monday nights, and I hope it will continue for many years. Thank you very much.
For you this year?
The best experience of my career. I learned a lot this year. Yeah, so musically it was amazing, met a lot of people. I DJed with the best. And you can only get better when you do that, you know?
What did you learn?
I think I learned just, you know, what every DJ needs to learn is reading a crowd, trying to incorporate your personal favorites that are in your box, in your record box, or and your DJ crate, whatever you call it. But then, you know, you understand that you're at a party, you gotta make people dance. So I've tried to educate while being educated by the crowd and learning, like, you know, what works, what doesn't, how I prefer to play in my own style. I've kind of come into my own as an artist as well, so it's been a really great experience this summer.
What happens when you're not in a party mood and you're not...
Yeah. Well, I eat too much when I'm not in a party mood. But I'm in the studio. That's my therapeutic time. Some people go to the beach. Some people travel to some crazy island. I go to the studio. That's what I do.
I mean, you have to mix.
Yeah.